talking about football, obviously it's an interesting, a slightly tough time for the game at the moment. I guess it's a serious question, but how big a problem do you think that prejudice and intolerance is at the top flight level?
Well, I mean, you have to keep things in perspective. You know, first and foremost, you know, it's 100% zero tolerance in terms of everybody supporting anybody that brings, comes forward and says that they've either been abused or you know, whether it's a supporter with chanting. You know, it's absolutely important that all of us together do as much as we can to make sure that there are zero incidents. But the reality is that we live in a society where unfortunately there is prejudice, and football is no different. And it's up to us, whether it's, you know, individually as at a club or the Football Association, to make sure that they deal with these cases when they come about. But there have been a couple of incidents in the last year, but overall the amount of good football has done for equality, for making sure different cultures are included. You only have to look at any football team and look at the different nationalities that are playing and the harmony within that team to see that football does a great job. And that's not just at sort of the top level, that's at grassroots all the way through. So, you know, I'm really proud of how far my sport's come in the 20 years that I've been involved with it. But there's always work to do, because it's about educating people and making sure that sort of that, you know, the ignorance that surrounds prejudice and racism is continually addressed.
I think obviously there have been some criticisms of the ineffectiveness perhaps of some of the bodies and the campaigns that are tackling particularly racism in the game. How do you feel about that? I mean, obviously you feel like there's been a lot of progress, but do you feel like there maybe perhaps needs to be more teeth to some of the campaigns that are attacking?
Not necessarily. I think the problem is that you know, any form of prejudice, it can, you have to have different sort of punishments for different crimes, so to speak, because it's a very complex issue. So, you know, you have to constantly look at what the disciplinary charges for particular offences. And I don't agree. I think, you know, I think all the governing body, you know, whether it's the FA, whether it's the Premier League, the rules and regulations at each club, I think are robust. But they're always open for change and check. And really for me, it's a case of each individual has a responsibility, whether you're a player, a supporter, somebody who works for a club. And I think as long as everybody sticks together, you know, we can continue to do our best to limit the amount of cases that occur within, you know, within football stadium. What happens outside is really hard for us to control. But what we do is try to educate people away, try to give them the information so that they, as young people, grow up seeing everybody as equal.